home, isn't it?
No, I think it's a little bit too early.
Gee, I wonder if he'll really bring us a present, like he promised us.
Oh, sure he will, but what do you think it will be?
I don't know.
Do you think it will be a toy? Or maybe a puppy? Maybe even a kitty?
Oh, I hope it's a little puppy. Hello there, Daddy.
Hi, kids.
What did you bring us, Daddy?
This.
What is it, Daddy?
Hello, John. You're early tonight.
Yes, I left the office a little early today and stopped at the pet shop and bought the kids a present.
Then it must be a little puppy. No, I'll bet it's a kitty.
Well, open it up and let's all take a look at it.
All right.
What is it, Daddy?
Well, honey, it's sort of an ugly duckling.
Well, I don't think it's ugly at all. I think it's beautiful.
Well, you know, that reminds me of a story. A story about the ugly duckling. Would you like to hear it? All right, then. I'll tell you the story if you promise to wash up for dinner right after I'm done.
Okay, Mommy, we promise.
This is how the story goes. Once upon a time, on a farm not far from here, there was a mother duck sitting on a nest full of eggs. Old Turkey Gobbler came along to say hello and have a little talk with Momma Duck. And for no reason at all, Momma Duck chased him away. He didn't know that Momma Duck was very, very worried. Neither did Old Lady Goose, who stopped by later to gossip a little bit. Momma Duck was very short with Old Lady Goose and didn't have a kind word. Momma Duck was certainly worried. And do you know why? Well, one of the eggs was so much bigger than the rest, and all of them were hatching just as they were supposed to, just like little duck eggs always do, all except one, the big one, the one that worried Momma Duck. But worried or not, Momma Duck climbed back on the nest, and she sat, and she worried, and she sat some more. And one day, out came the biggest, whitest, ugliest little duckling that ever was. Much bigger than all the other ducklings, and much, much uglier. Well, you can imagine that Momma Duck was very, very worried indeed. So what do you think she did? She decided to test them by taking them all swimming. She knew that if the big, white, ugly duckling couldn't swim, he wasn't a duckling at all. So she started for the pond, which was nearby. The little ducklings jumped right into the water. But would the big, white, ugly one? The little ones did, and so did the big, white, ugly duckling. And he swam beautifully. Well, as you can guess, Momma Duck was very, very proud as she watched all her little ducklings play. Everything was all right at first. But the big, white, ugly duckling was much too big and white and ugly for the other ducklings. And he swam away and left him all alone. He had no friends to play with. All the other little ducklings had friends to play with, but the big, white, ugly duckling had no friends at all. While all the others played together and had a fine time, he was alone. So he set out to find some friends for himself, and he thought he found some. They looked at him, and he looked at them, and they even swam out to where he was. But they had no time for big, white, ugly ducklings. It was nearly fall, and they had to fly south for the winter. So they left him all alone and wouldn't play with him and went off by themselves. Well, the ugly duckling was very discouraged and very lonely, and he decided to go off on land and hunt for friends. Maybe on land he'll find some friends. He waddled through the fields of flowers, hurrying to find friends, hurrying to put an end to his loneliness. Up in the barnyard, there were some very dignified geese, and the ugly duckling asked them to play with him. But they were too dignified. They were too big to bother with a little white, ugly duckling. Oh, what was wrong with the ugly duckling? First, much, much too big for the small ducklings, and then much, much too small for the big, dignified geese. Days and days and even weeks went by, and the weather got colder and colder, and the ugly duckling got bigger and bigger and uglier, until finally, the ugly duckling was as big as the geese, but twice as ugly. And still he had found no friends. No friends to warm his heart in the cold woods. No friends to stop his loneliness. Then, one day, while he was walking through the cold woods, with his head hanging down in loneliness, he fell right smack in a hole, and he got stuck there, unable to move. Nearby, at the edge of the woods, there lived a friendly farmer. He often used to walk through the woods, and one day, as he was out walking, he saw the ugly duckling in the hole and decided to take him home. So the ugly duckling felt strong, friendly hands lift him and carry him through the woods and take him into the house. And the friendly farmer put him down in front of the stove and smiled at how happy the ugly duckling was. For the ugly duckling was very happy. It seemed as though he had never had any friends, and it seemed as though he had never been warm. It was wonderful to have friends and to be warm. Well, the farmer's cat saw the ugly duckling, and he said, "Hey, you, that's my place there in front of the stove. You just get away from there. I don't let anybody take my place." So the ugly duckling sighed and moved away. And over on the other side of the room, the farmer's hen started talking as soon as the ugly duckling came in sight. "I have enough trouble around here with your big webbed feet and your ugly white face to bother me, too. I try to keep this place neat and clean, and I don't think you would be any help at all. If you want to stay until you get warm, it's all right. But no longer. You'll find no friends here, and I don't want you around. I run this place, you know, and you wouldn't fit in." Well, finally, it was more than the ugly duckling could bear. So he left the house and set off once again in the cold woods. All alone, without any friends, he wandered through the woods until one day he came to a granary, a place where corn and wheat are stored. Nobody was there, no friends, but no enemies either. And he decided that this was a good place to spend the winter, for at least there was plenty of food in the granary. So, while the winter winds howled outside and the snow blew furiously, the ugly duckling gradually grew. Finally, winter ended and spring came. And by this time, the ugly duckling was a beautiful, full-grown swan, and he was very lonely. He still thought he was just an ugly duckling with no hope of finding friends. But it was spring, and he thought he would have just one more try before giving up his search for friends. Well, the ugly duckling went on back to the pond because he felt more at home there. As he looked around, all he saw were his old enemies, the geese. He knew they would laugh at him because he was so ugly. But on the other side of the pond, he saw some strange birds that he had never seen before. Never in all his life had he seen birds so beautiful, so graceful. Oh, how he wished that he were like them, that he could be beautiful and graceful too. The ugly duckling was sad. He was afraid to play with the new birds because they might laugh at him. But as he swam by himself and hung his head in sorrow, he saw his own reflection in the water. Then, in an instant, he realized he was just like the beautiful birds he had just seen. He was not an ugly duckling at all, but a beautiful swan. And he would never be ashamed or afraid anymore. So you see, children, no one should ever be ashamed or worried about the way he looks, because everyone is beautiful in his own way. And when he realized this, the ugly duckling stayed in the pond with his new friend, lived happily ever after.